Hi, I'm Effie and I'm a student supervisor at the Jacobs Hall Makerspace. And in this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the process of laser cutting a simple finger joint box using Rhino. This tutorial assumes that you have a basic understanding of these tools. So if you're unfamiliar with Rhino, you may want to check out our Rhino resources through the link in our description below. But if you feel like you're ready, let's open up Rhino and get started.
So the first thing we'll do is create a box of your desired size by modeling the actual walls. So I'm going to make the interior of my box 4 by 4 by 4 inches, where each wall is 1/8 of an inch thick. Then I'm going to create smaller boxes after that. But first, let's make these larger walls. So 4 by 0.125 by 4 inches tall. And I'm going to turn my perspective into shaded mode, just so it's a bit easier to see. I'm going to copy this to the edge, and then move it by 4 inches in the y-axis. Then I can copy these two walls, rotate them 90 degrees, and all that's left to do is make the bottom wall. So from there to there, and -0.125. Great, now I'm going to create smaller boxes that are 1/8 of an inch wide, and 1/2 of an inch tall. So 1/8 of an inch box, square box, -0.5 inches down. Then I'm going to copy this all the way down. Awesome. Now I'm going to select the ones I just made and copy them to all the other corners. Okay, now to do the bottom edges, I'm going to take this, rotate it. I'll copy it first and then rotate it 90 degrees, move it into place, move it here, and then instead of copying, you can also use the array command. So let's say I think I want 9 in the x direction, and for spacing, click here and here. That looks great. Then I'm going to use scale 1D to scale this down to where I need it to be. Cool. Then I'm just going to take this, copy it, rotate it, move it to place again. This I should scale down. I'm also going to need to scale down this. Okay, select these, copy, rotate, move, and one last time, copy, rotate. Once I have these smaller boxes along every edge, I can use Boolean Union. Select each face one at a time, and then select alternating finger joints to attach along each of its edges. And when I finish a Boolean Union, I like to hide it just so I can see what has been unioned and what hasn't. So for the next one. Okay, so after I've repeated this for each face, I'm gonna turn on all my walls, show them again, and I need to turn these walls into 2D lines so I can laser cut. So I'm going to first go into the top view, select my bottom wall, and use the make 2D command to make it into 2D lines. For this step, you just want to make sure that you're in the correct active viewport where you're looking at the wall head on. You might need a mirror some things to get them in place. Okay, great. Going back into top view now. So I've only done make 2D to three of the walls. The reason I can do this is because I made the front and back walls symmetrical and the left and right wall symmetrical. So that means I only have to make one of each and then I can just mirror it over to create a copy of it. So once I have these make 2D lines, we need to make a couple adjustments. Because the laser cutter is removing some amount of material while it cuts, we need to adjust for what's called the curve. So we have to offset our finger joints by a certain distance outwards. And this may take some experimenting on your laser cutter depending on how well honed it is at the moment, as well as how tight of a fit you want for your box. For now, I'll adjust mine outwards by 0.005 inches. So I'm going to join one of the sides, in this segment, and then offset it by 0.05. And for me, this is where it usually gets a little finicky. So I like to keep these outer edges offset, but I found that generally, if you keep the original line for the inner edges, it produces a bit of a tighter fit. So I'm going to explode the offset line I just made, delete these lines, and then use extend to intersect the original with the offset. Okay, then you can delete this original line and fill in the gaps. Then you can select all of those and rejoin them. And another benefit of creating your walls as symmetrical as possible is I can just delete the other side and mirror this over. Great. Now I just need to do the bottom edge, join, offset, explode, delete. And extend. And then because you've offset these edges outwards, you might need to go back into the corners and make sure that they meet. When you have all the edges done, you can join this entire wall into one closed curve. And make sure it's a closed curve, otherwise you have a gap somewhere. All right, so now I'm gonna repeat this process for all three of these walls. Great, now that I have all of these walls offset, I can just mirror these. And And you might need to mirror them again in order for them to line up properly. Okay, I have all my walls now. And that's really all you need to do to prepare a file for finger joint box. You can export this file as a DXF and import it into Illustrator to change line weights and stroke colors as needed for your laser cutter. When laser cutting at Jacobs Hall, make sure you've completed the training and are following all the correct safety protocols. On top of this, you can make this basic box and turn it into as fancy or simple of a design as you want by adding engravings, rasters, cutouts, and more. You could make this an open top box with a corresponding lid, or a box that has an unconventional number of faces. So have fun experimenting and stay safe laser cutting.